Solving quadratic equations is the lesson we are going to take today. Now, solving quadratic equations, we basically have four methods. There is what we call the Bulldozer method, factorization method, completing squares method, and then there also what we call the graphical method. There are others, but the common ones are these four, and they are the ones we are going to cover. The graphical method, we shall see it later. Let us start with the Bulldozer method. This is a method of using a formula to solve the quadratic equation. For this quadratic equation, the Bulldozer method is this. When you reach A level or higher levels, you will see how this formula is got from completing squares. Anyway, this is the method you use. In simple terms, you just compare. You need A, you need B, you need C, and A. So let us see the questions. Solve the following using the Bulldozer method. They give you such an equation. And then they give, what you do, you compare. A, you write the general quadratic equation, and the general quadratic equation is this. Then after that, we compare. The coefficient of x squared here is a, here is 1, so a is 1. The coefficient of x here is b, here is 5. C, as simple as that. Then after, we substitute into the formula. You need this formula is behind the tables. So your a will be now negative a2. Your b is 5. Then plus or minus square root of our b is 5 squared. Minus 4 into our a is 1. Then our c is 6. The whole over. This should be from here to here. 2 into a, which is 1. Some people bring it from here up to here. It should be from here up to here. So this is our 6 place. So then this will be now minus 5 plus or minus square root of 5 squared is 25 minus 4 times 6, that is 24. Now all over 2 times this you get 2. Then you see that this 25 minus this will give us 1. So this will be now, okay, x will be negative 5 plus or minus square root of a 1. The whole over 2. Square root of a 1 would be now minus 5 plus or minus square root of 1 is 1. The whole over a 2. Now from there we separate. How we separate? So our x now is, now you first take the upper sign. It's going to be minus 5 plus now 1 over 2. Or our x is going to be, now you take the lower sign. This negative 5 now minus a 1, the whole over a 2. You see, this will give us x will be negative 4 over 2, which is x is going to be a negative 2. Negative 5 plus 1, we get negative 4 divided by 2, we get negative 2. Then here we have negative 5 minus 5 will give us a negative 6 over 2, and so our x will be a negative 3. Here, what we need to take this step, negative 5, you have two signs here. You take this with the upper first, which is positive, then you take the other side with this, you are taking it with this negative sign down. Let us come to this. Now we have our variable is in y. So this is changing. It can change from x to m to y to q, any. So let's see that it's in y. You also use it in y. So our a is 4. Our b is negative. Our b is negative. We need sign. We need sign negative. C is also negative 6. So putting in our formula there is that we have now y equal to minus b. Minus b, which is minus 5. You use this bracket always. Plus or minus square root of b squared, negative 5, the whole square, then minus 4 into a, minus 4. Then into b, minus 4a, then into 4a, minus 4, then minus c, is negative 6. I'm putting there. Then the wall, you see mine is from there. Then 2 into a 4. Then our y, from here, let us simplify and see what we have. So our y will be minus minus, we have a 5, then plus or minus square root of 25, when you square this, you get 25. When you square another 25, you get 25. A minus and a minus, we get a positive. So you say 4 times 4 times 6, that will give you a 96. So this will give us, this plus this will give us a 96. The whole thing over 8. 2 times 4. So this negative and this negative will give us this positive. 8 times 6, you get 96. Okay, let us simplify. We have 5 plus 1 minus root of. Now we will add this, you get 121 over 8. Square root of. So this will be now 5 plus 1 minus square root of 121 is 11 over 8. Now from there, we take our, like we say, you take the, this with the positive first. So our will be now 5 plus 11 over 8. This with the positive, or our will be now 5 with a minus down. A minus 5 minus 11 over 8. Okay, so here 5 plus 11, that's 16, divided by 8, that will be 2. So that's y. Then 5 minus this, this will be negative 6 over 8, which will reduce by 2, we get negative 3, by 2, we get a 4. So these are the roots. So these are the roots. And also here, these are the roots. So now, please try out this in your free time. Just use everything. Make sure the answer you are going to get here, you are going to get now to similar values. As yes. Okay, let me do it for you here. Okay, so my x is going to be minus b, which is negative 6, plus or minus square root of my b, negative 6, square b, then minus. My b is negative 6, then minus a 4 into 1, then my c is a 9. The whole over 2 times a, which is 1. So allow me to do it here. So now we have x equaling 2. This minus and the minus, we get 6. Then plus 1 minus, square root of. When you square negative 6, we get 36. Then minus. 4 times 1, 4 times 9, 36. The whole over 2 into 1. Our x becomes 6 plus or minus root of 0. The whole over 2, which will give us now 6 plus or minus square root of 0 is 0 over 2. Means that now my x will be 6 plus 0 over 2. Of my x will be 6 minus 0 over 2. Just like here, 6 plus 0 is 6, divided by 2, you get 3. Or my x will be 6 minus 0, 6 divided by 2, 3. So this one was repeated. The values are the same. So that's it, members. I wish you well.